Ohio has many advantages that other states don't, and one of them is that we're within 600 miles of 60% of the nation's population. That makes our state a great place to be for businesses that need to quickly deliver their products to customers. But it also means we have to keep our highways in absolute peak condition. Ohio has faced a $1.6 billion highway budget deficit that threatens to slow down badly needed highway maintenance and new construction. Well, we can't let our roads fall apart. That would hurt Ohio's economy, and it would absolutely cost us jobs. Nor can we raise our gas tax. That would cost us jobs also. Instead, we've got to think outside the box and find new, innovative ways to pay for our roads and our highways. One solution is the Ohio Turnpike. Built nearly 60 years ago across northern Ohio, the Turnpike produces annual toll revenues of approximately $270 million a year, far beyond what's needed to operate the road. Ohio has never considered tapping this asset to help meet our highway needs, but we need to be creative if we want to keep our state moving. After a year-long study of the Turnpike and a great deal of consideration, my administration has concluded that Ohio should not lease the Turnpike to a private company. Instead, we propose leaving the Turnpike intact under its existing commission and raising $1.5 billion for Ohio's highways by issuing bonds backed by the Turnpike's excess profits. This $1.5 billion investment by Ohio could actually result in as much as $3 billion in total construction spending when matched with local and federal money and generate an estimated, get this, 75,000 jobs. And because Ohio keeps control of the Turnpike instead of leasing it, we can keep the tolls low. Jerry, tell us more.
Thanks, Governor. The Turnpike is a valuable asset to northern Ohio and the rest of the state as well. It connects major population areas and links virtually all of Ohio's major interstates to traffic going east and west. If Ohio can better integrate this asset into the rest of the state's highway system with a more robust statewide approach and help provide the funds to do it, then the state's economy can receive an important boost because we will be able to do more projects sooner. Ohio is poised to take that step with $1.5 billion in new money from Ohio's highways. And Ohioans get that new money without losing control of our Turnpike and without the big toll increases that a private operator may bring. In fact, we're going to freeze tolls on local passenger trips using Easy Pass for 10 years and cap future toll increases at the rate of inflation. That's far below the Turnpike's past increases. Let's be clear. This might not generate as much money as a lease to a private company, but it allows Ohio to keep control of the Turnpike, avoid disruptive changes, and hold down tolls. It's a balanced plan that provides the funds Ohio's roads and our economy needs while preserving the Turnpike in a way Ohioans want.
You know, I have to tell you, I'm very excited about the innovative approach we're taking to keep Ohio's highways in top form. Though it doesn't change the Turnpike much, it's still a new approach, and there are always some who are threatened by change and who will criticize it. But look at what this means. Ohio will have $1.5 billion in new funds that, when combined with matching local and federal dollars, could mean as much as $3 billion to build more road projects sooner. And these projects, again, will generate 75,000 jobs. And local passenger trip tolls won't change for 10 years. And all other tolls will be capped at the rate of inflation, which is more than half the rate of the Turnpike's increases of the past 20 years.
One thing the study revealed, and it will surprise many people, is that Ohio's major interstates are actually in better overall condition than the Ohio Turnpike. The Turnpike's large maintenance costs keep it patched up, but it needs to be brought up to the higher quality level of the rest of Ohio's interstate system. This proposal will actually provide more dollars for Turnpike upgrades, and they'll be made faster than they would have otherwise.
As Ohioans continue to create new jobs and get our state back on its feet, it's critically important that we keep our transportation infrastructure in good condition everywhere. By leveraging the Turnpike's untapped resources, while keeping it under state control in the way it is now, and keeping a rein on tolls, we can begin to solve Ohio's highway funding crisis in a balanced and thoughtful way. I look forward to working with the Ohio General Assembly to make this plan a reality, and I urge you to learn more about it. For more information, visit OhioTurnpikeAnalysis.com. Again, visit OhioTurnpikeAnalysis.com. Thanks, and I hope to see you all real soon.